is an introduction video about RBox, which is a short name for remote box. RBox is a lightweight Linux system built with build root, specifically designed for securely accessing your IoT box when connected to the internet. When you connect RBox based hardware to the internet, it acts as a chatbot using XMPP protocol. This means RBox needs a login account on public XMPP server for remote access. As of now, RBox image is available for Raspberry Pi B and B Plus model. In this video, I'm going to explain you about how to create RBox based bootable SD card for Raspberry Pi B and B Plus model. Okay, let's get started. Here is the download link for exit compressed initial SD card image. Download this image to your PC. The image size is about 44 megabytes in size. You can use your favorite decompression tool. In my case, it's 7-zip. Once you have unzipped SD image, insert the SD card into your Windows machine and a new drive would show up. I use famous Win32 disk imager for writing the image to SD card. Ensure that the selected drive is the correct one. Once the image is written to SD card, create a text file called xmpp-login.txt under boot drive of your SD card. Fill this file with valid username and password for the public XMPP server login. Now your SD card is ready to boot Raspberry Pi. Remove the card from your Windows machine and insert it into Pi. Next step is, using PSI Jabber client, log into XMPP server with master account's username and password. Notice that PSI client takes a bit longer time, it's about 45 seconds for logging into XMPP server, whereas Android Jabber client is much faster in server login. Once the master account goes online, blinking stops and the star symbol stays solid yellow. As shown here, master account has already added slave in its contact list, but the slave is still offline. That's because we haven't switched on the Raspi yet. Let's switch on the Raspi and wait for it to go online. As you can see in PSI client, the slave contact starts blinking to indicate that the Raspi is coming online now. Blinking star stays solid yellow once the Raspi is online. Right click on the slave and open chat window. Type help. And you will get a response with a list of available commands. Let's try to read the current version of the RBox Linux distribution. Okay, here it is. Let's see what's the current host name of Raspi chatbot. Here it is. Let's read the status of Raspi GPIO2. It is 1. Let's change it to 0 and read it back. As you can see, we have written 0. You can try out different commands as given here. And let me know your feedback in the comment section. Thanks for watching this video and see you next time with more interesting videos on RBox.